In this video, we explore what are known as defensive design considerations, and in particular, the concept of data validation. Validation is checking data inputted by the user meets specific requirements or rules before processing. There are five validation checks which you need to be aware of for GCSE. The first is a type check. Was data entered of the correct data type? For example, if a program is expecting a number, but a character is input instead, it will likely crash. The programmer can resolve this by working with inputs as strings rather than casting them to numbers. For example, here we have the code choice equals int input enter your choice. This is not the best way of programming this because the program will crash if it cannot convert the input to an integer. It would be better to program it like this instead. A range check. Was the data entered in the correct range? For example, if a quantity is to be entered, then the minimum value must be 1. There is often an upper range too, so perhaps the input must be restricted for between 1 to 10. Presence check. The user might not enter any data at all. There may be certain required fields, for example, entering your email address when using online forms before continuing. How will your program cope with no data being entered? Will the input be treated as a null or empty string or as a zero? A format check. Some data needs to be entered in the correct format. An obvious example is a date, and you could enter this in a number of formats, for example, 2 digits for the day, 2 for the month, and 4 for the year. Postcodes and item codes often have specific formats that need to be adhered to. These can be checked for processing. And finally, a length check. Some data items must be a specific number of characters or over a specific minimum number of characters. Barcodes are 13 digits, for example, and passwords are often required to be at least 6 characters or more. By using input validation techniques, a programmer can make their program more robust, more user-friendly, and prevent further errors occurring. Here is a quick summary of the 5 data validation techniques we've gone through. Pause the video and take some notes.